In this example, the figure shows a spiral of inner radius A and outer radius B with total N turns wound in it. And we are given that our current I flows in it. We are required to find the magnetic induction at the center of the spiral, that is at point O. Now in this situation, if along the radial direction, we'll find out the number of turns per unit length, per unit radial length, then it can be given as N upon B minus A, because in the distance of B minus A, there are total N turns found, it is given to us. So to find the magnetic induction at point O, let we consider at a distance x from O, a small elemental coil which is of width dx. Now if we consider a coil of width dx, then we can see number of turns in an elemental coil of radius x and width dx is, this can be written as dn, that will be n upon b minus a into dx, because in the length b minus a there are n turns, so in the length dx number of turns, radial length dx number of turns will be n upon b minus a into dx. Now we can simply get the value of magnetic induction due to this elemental coil at O is, this can be written as dB, and as being a circular coil, here we can consider this coil to be a complete circle which is of width dx. Then for this coil of width dx at center O, magnetic induction we can write as mu naught I by 2x multiplied by number of turns, which is n by b minus a into dx. Now we can simply integrate it and get the total magnetic induction at O is, this B will be integration of dB, and here all constant mu naught I n by twice of B minus A can be taken out of the sign of integration. Inside it is dx by x, will integrate it within limits from A to B for x. So on integrating we are getting mu naught I n by twice of b minus a, and its integration is ln x, we apply limits from a to b. So directly the magnetic induction at O, we are getting mu naught I n by twice of b minus a. This will be ln b minus ln a, which can be written as ln of b by a. That will be the answer to this problem.